Ouch, my vagina.
Hello tonight. I'm CJ. This is the RockWire. What I have for you tonight is a double shot from Beefcake Brad's, one of his many favorite bands, but this is right up there. It's like Papa Roach. It's like Blackstone Cherry. It's like Def Leppard. It's like Bowling for Soup. And somewhere down around 5, 6, or 7 is Otherwise. We got double shot. They got new EP, 2 new bangers. Brad, how are you doing tonight?
I'm stoked because, you know, as you're saying, I got to get my game face on. Adrian, the lead singer of Otherwise, always brings the game face. He's a bald guy like me, and every time I'm in his shows, he like points me out. He's like singing directly to me. I would die for you.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, I was gonna make a bald joke that you only like him because he's bald too later in the episode, but you beat me to it.
Is that before or after you throw your underwear on stage?
He actually put it on his mic stand once.
All right. With the dead man's hand. Derek from the Badlands, how are you tonight, buddy? Man, fresh off your Denver vacation. We'll get to that later. What's going on? How you feeling?
I'm refreshed. I'm ready to just beat the hell out of Beefcake. Let's go.
All right. Right into it, man. Double shot from the band Otherwise. We have Exit. Or you know what? You take it away, Brad.
Well, Exit Wound is the latest song that just dropped last week. I think it's a great song. Adrian's vocals, I feel like, really drives this song. I thought it was really ironic, though, to hear that slapping bass pick. Pretty great. I don't regret picking this song, by the way. It's back to the original roots. I am so glad, and I keep telling them when I message them all the time, I'm like, you guys are back to your roots. I'm glad. Derek, what'd you think of this bass slapping song?
God, you have like a love affair with them or something. I don't know what's going on. It's kind of creepy, to be honest.
I know, it's like he's the humping the stuffed dog from last week's
episode. Yeah, I think Brad's in heat. For Otherwise. Exit Wound is funny because when I listened to it, I thought, it's like a mashup of punk and rock, and it was like empty calories for me. I almost thought like Courtney Love was going to start singing on it, you know? It's gonna be over, whatever the hell that song is. I'm not a big Courtney Love fan.
Doll Parts is the song you're thinking of.
I thought this song was lame. Every time I started listening to it, I kept trying to fast forward because I kept wanting to skip it. Skip it. Not that good. Like I said, empty calories. I didn't like it. No, it's too punk, weird. No.
Oh, my gosh.
All right. All right. So yeah. The two-song EP, Exit Wound, the title track, the latest one, Exit Wound. So it comes right in with the bass intro. And I thought it was a very interesting song lyrically. No big driving riffs that I thought were particularly memorable. You know, I did watch the video, and
it's pretty good.
What I was trying to determine is, what exactly is this song about? Now, the hook is living my life like an exit wound. So is Brad living his life on the ragged edge, where he could die at any moment, or is this a song with some self-harm overtones? Because God knows in the video, there's lots of hand gesturing. He's got it in the temple. He's got it under his chin. He blows some confetti out of the back of his brain at the end. And you know what? That's it's kind of some dangerous symbolism to portray in a music video in today's age. And you know what? That's fine. I definitely don't want him self-censoring the band on that front, and to each his own. But what's your take on it? What,
you know, I took it as this is a song is about a release. It's about something going through you and you're surviving it. You know, the exit wound, it's coming out of you. And the way Derek has been ripping on this song, you know, it's kind of the same way. I mean, this song is like Swiss cheese. It just goes right through it, and it keeps building, and it gets stronger with it over time. It's going to really build.
No, it's like Swiss cheese. It just blew right past me. What has happened?
All right, well, we broke it down. Derek didn't like it. I'm Luke Warren. Brad is in love with everything Otherwise does. You be the judge.
Oh.
Exit Wound, Otherwise.
Otherwise, this is Kim Kardashian.
Which brings us to 3 months ago with the next song on the double shot, Full Disclosure. Set it up, Brad.
Well, you know, I wanted to bring it this song 3 months ago, obviously, but we were on a little hiatus again. I just love the tempo and the patterns of the song. To me, it was full. It was very rich. It was so evenly written that you could feel every musical instrument in the song. That's what I felt.
So, you know, to me, this is a straight-ahead rock song, more or less. I wouldn't call it any punk vibe or metalcore. This is just a rock song from a rocking band. And full disclosure, you don't know who I'm messing with. I'm going to beat your ass backstage. That's what he wants. He wants to fight someone backstage. Otherwise, he's ready to fight. Somebody made fun of his beautiful bald head, and there we go. That's all I got on this one. Should I just skip Derek over?
I got a feeling
this is not going to get any better.
He never even listened to those songs.
Full disclosure, that song kicks ass. That song was good. That's why I kept wanting to skip that lame one, because I wanted to listen to this, the Full Disclosure, again. I mean, it's funny because Exit Wound had a little explicit E by it, and then Full Disclosure didn't. I'm thinking, all I hear is F-bombs on Full Disclosure. So I don't understand how they got that, but no.
What streaming service is that from?
YouTube.
Okay.
But the lyrics are cool. The way he is... cadence was super cool. The way they did the chorus, like sing song and boom, coming in hard. I mean, this was a beast of a song. This song was great. It's like the tale of two cities with this band. The first song, lame as hell, and the second song is one of the best songs I've heard in a long time. So I think they need to really realize that, man, that's where the bread is buttered, because that song kicks ass. I love Full Disclosure. I'd listen to it right now if I could.
All right,
Full Disclosure, I'm telling you, I would.
In Derek's opinion, they have totally redeemed themselves. Otherwise, Full Disclosure. Now, Brad, Otherwise, from Las Vegas, Nevada, this is their fifth studio album down. Two song double shot EP. Tell me more.
Well, you know, when I first met them back in, they actually came to my town, and I got to party with them. We played shuffleboard in a bar.
Oh, I love shuffleboard in
a bar. Oh, dude, it was so cool. And we all drank them, which was funny.
Well, they got showed you.
They were a 5-piece band originally. And now they're only a 4-piece. So their first 3 albums, I think they were a 5-piece. And I really liked them. What's that?
Did they kill the guy? What happened to the fifth guy?
No, they've had, if you, when you look at their members, they have lost so many members. It's like they've lost 18 people.
I was looking at their membership as well. Yes, a lot of names in the column of former members on
right.
Wikipedia. But what I believe happened, and correct me if I'm wrong, is they dropped a rhythm guitarist. They had a rhythm guitarist originally, right. And that is bye-bye because we only got four mouths to feed in this bus.
Well, they dropped a rhythm guitarist. They lost their bass player and the drummer several different times over that period of time. When they came out with their, in 2017, I think it was, where they had their Sleeping with Lions album, I thought they lost a beat. And I was really like, I was really hard on them. And Adrian, actually, I think it was your Facebook, actually messaged me, hey, if you like our hardcore stuff, we're going to get back to it. We're going to get back to it. And lo and behold, these new songs with the new two band members, the drummer and the bass player, they sound like they're going back to the roots. And that, to me, I'd love it. That's what I want to hear. I want to hear that hardcore otherwise.
Yeah, I don't want to hear a hardcore Bowling for Soup band, though. I mean...
Oh, that's my favorite. You guys know it.
Yeah, I know, but we want something good. And that Full Disclosure was awesome.
Right.
I want more of that.
So, we know about Soldiers because we've done the Memorial Day episode on songs about war or battle, and Brad always wants to make sure that otherwise Soldiers is included. That's their number one most popular song on Spotify. Derek, did you have any opportunities? No, let me rephrase. Did you take any opportunities to check out any of their other material, not being highly familiar with this band? It's okay to say no.
No.
Well, I'm gonna remind you guys. We talked about Crossfire and Lifted already once.
Now I have been listening to Otherwise a little this week. I've been popping them around. So Lifted, I love. I think that is a really good song, and that might be one of their better riffs as far as coming in on the guitar. And what was the other one?
Die for You is my favorite. But.
Die for You is the Beefcake Brad approved favorite song.
I'll listen to him. You know what, Brad? Just for you, because like you have a love affair with Otherwise. I have a long distance love affair with you.
Well,
and I want to check them out for you.
Die for you and Crossfire. I just got done watching the Crossfire video about half an hour ago.
I would die for you in the Crossfire, Brad. Die for you in the Crossfire. Because I'm a soldier of love.
Will your wife send you to my wedding or no?
it would be the gift to Brad if you could only be there. And as always, if you're watching this on YouTube, check out the show on Spotify. Get the entire show with full-length songs edited right in with the Anchor Music tool. Runs just like a radio show. YouTube, see ya.
Later.
Eric's on top.
You guys can kiss my lily white ass.